What do we do when the oil is all gone? Is this reminding yourself to...
Well, that is one that pops up in my head once in a while, and what will we do? How are you going to run a car?
Oh, you're talking about actual...
You're going to use coal?
See, I thought when I saw this sign, I really thought you were just reminding yourself to call the heating people.
No, I'm looking
at... This is metaphysical.
Much further.
This is...
Okay, here's some older ones. These, I think, were made in the 70s. And they're better than some of the later ones. They're character faces. Like these are getting into the smaller ones, and here we have smaller yet. The smaller, the better. And when you make a tiny scene, you're saving material, you're saving space, you're saving everything. Energy, mainly energy. If you're working for Hollywood, the material and the space is nothing. They have it all. But energy is what counts. The subconscious aspect of animation is the fact that it's concentrated energy. It's the energy that was put into every frame, that all the intricate movements that go on have to be taken care of every frame. The camera captures the light, and there it is. I've got one story about the little conquistador. He's kind of like the Speedy Alka-Seltzer kid. He's very wan and pale and of a very unsubstantial build with a wispy little beard. Even though he never got to be over, he had arrested development at 6 years old, though he did have a tiny beard. By some magic, he became a giant midget. A giant midget is a shrimp who gets to be about 60 feet tall. sometimes there's a macrocosm and a microcosm. And if you're dyslexic like me, you can't tell the difference.